Hola, ¿cómo estás? Bien, ¿y tú? Hi, my name is Ashley Newman and I'm the assistant cook.
My name is Afia Verde, I'm also the assistant chef.
My name is Nina Kumar and I'm the chef.
And welcome to Cooking by the Book, your local 1860s cooking show.
Right now, we'll be making chicken pie, a favorite among the soldiers. During the Civil War, it was a delicacy to eat this pie. Many soldiers don't know how to cook, so we'll be teaching them how to make this beloved meal.
To make the pie, we need two pie crusts, 1/3 cup of butter, 1/3 cup of onions, 1/3 cup of flour, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/4 teaspoons of pepper, 1 3/4 cup of chicken broth, 1/2 cup of milk, 2 1/2 cups of chicken, and 2 cups of vegetables.
First, you want to heat your oven to 425 Fahrenheit. If you don't have an oven, you just use your fire pit. Then in a pan, melt butter over a medium heat. Add onion. And then cook for 2 minutes, stirring thinly until tender. Stir in flour. And then add some salt. And pepper. Gradually stir in broth. And then the milk, cooking and stirring into bubbly and thickened.
Then you will want to stir in chicken. And mixed vegetables. And remove and mix it. Then remove from heat and spoon chicken mixture into a crust pan, top with second crust, and then seal. Top pie with another piece of crust, take a fork and make the edges, then take a knife and make 4 slits to release steam, and then coat it with egg wash to make sure that it cooks well.
Then you can go to the oven and bake it for 30 or 40 minutes or until it's golden brown. So the pie is ready to bake, we'll take a quick commercial break. Friends and soldiers, preparing to fight in the Civil War, are you looking for a war dog? Well, we have the perfect place for you to visit. Introducing to you, Ramsey, the best dog in our shelter. He's one of the most skilled dogs in our shelter. Even though all of our dogs are very skilled, Ramsey's is the best. Make sure you come to our shelter today. Our address is 2323 Boy Boy West Coast Road.
Welcome to Cooking by the Book, your local 1860s cooking show.
The chicken pie is cooked and ready to eat.
That's all for the cooking show. We'll see you next time.
Again, I'm Sophia Verde, an assistant chef.
I'm Nina Kumara, I'm the chef.
And I'm Ashley, an assistant cook.
And thank you for watching.
Now that you watch our cooking show, it's time to get into the history of the role of food and cookbooks during the Civil War.
Cookbooks published during the Civil War era provided vivid, contrasting portraits of how the conflict affected diets and social life in the North and South. A house divided against itself. Indeed, there were very little in common between the kitchens of the Yankee North and the Confederate South.
Over the 40-year course of the war, the cotton and tobacco growing South was steadily starved into submission by the Union's naval blockade of the Atlantic coast and the Mississippi River, which cut off vital supplies of grain, pork, and most lethally salt. Meanwhile, ports in the North remained open to trade with Europe.
While parts of the South came close to famine, the North continued to dine well and even exported surplus food. All this was reflected in the food literature of the time.
A rare but explicit reference to slavery in a Northern cookbook appeared is Mrs. S.G. Knight Tidbits, or How to Prepare a Nice Dish at a Moderate Expense. It contains a recipe called Tessie's Wheaten Biscuit from a contraband. Contraband being the term used by the army for slaves who had escaped across Union lines.
Written in broken English to mimic the speech of a slave, the short recipe used a touch of black comedy, unsavory to our modern ears. To evoke the cruelty of plantation life, it directed readers to beat the dough until its beak begins to go pop, 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 I'll crack most like a whip. Then you know it's done.
The only other cookbook of the year was the Confederate Recipe Book, published in 1863. It had a revealing subtitle, a compilation of over 100 recipes adapted to the times. And those were the worst of times. Those miserably manifested in a recipe for apple pie without apples. To 1 small bowl of crackers that have been soaked into no hard parts remain. Add 1 teaspoonful of tartaric acid, sweet to your taste, add some butter and a very little nutmeg.
Perhaps the most serious result of the food blockade was the lack of salt which the South imported from Wales. Fish, meat, butter, and other foodstuffs could not be preserved without salt and perished rapidly in the heat. The army ran out of provision, and on the home front, too, hunger grew.
What remained plentiful in the South were protein rich peanuts and black eyed peas, both of which, ironically enough, were brought from the West Africa by very slaves over whom the war was being fought.
Since slave women did most of the cooking in the Antebellum Mansions, it's rather surprising that one of the first cookbooks to be published was by a black woman in America was by an ex-slave.
Thank you again for watching.
Bye! Bye.